Hello, I'm here for round one on the play. All right, I'll keep this. It's not really fair to say that the mana is bad. If this were in a mongoose, I would still keep this hand. This hand's really, really good. And even just as a six card hand, it's extremely good. I'm pretty much not gonna daze anything on turn one because I want to be able to use Wasteland on turn two. This is one of the main reasons to play Delver, is you often will have very, very fast starts like this. Sometimes you can also win very quickly. Looks like my opponent mulliganed to four. Yeah, four cards. Okay. Well, my opponent played around Stifle and Wasteland, but I still feel advantaged. I feel tropical. Well, I can just play a lot of stupid creatures. Don't really know what my opponent's playing. It's possible my opponent's playing Miracles, and what's this Miracle Terminus next turn, but I'm not gonna play around that. Alright, Bolts is revealed. That's gonna be the end of the game. Yeah, my opponent is certainly dead. I'll just play the Wasteland. I'll throw a Lightning Bolt at my opponent. I'm not going to kill my opponent just in case I get to see a little bit extra information. Alright, well, I still don't know what my opponent's playing, but I got some information. My opponent is playing a deck with a basic island. It's likely that my removal is not very good. Pretty safe to bring in Pyroblast. And then maybe Flusterstorm and Thoughtseize. Not really sure about Needle and Cage. My opponent could be playing Reanimator. That's a deck that can mulligan really low and still think that they're gonna win. I'm not confident in that enough to bring in Cage. I'm just gonna bring in these four disruptive spells: Pyroblast, Flusterstorm, Thoughtseize. And take out two Lightning Bolts and two Dismembers. And I'll be back for game. Hello, here for game two on the draw. My opponent kept seven. I'll also keep. Stifle definitely gets worse on the draw compared to the play, but it's still such a powerful card that I often leave it in. It is one of the cards that you can board out. A lot of the cards are just, I would never consider boarding them out. Like any of the cantrips or Delver. I have boarded out the other creatures or trimmed them a little bit sometimes. Oh, Cabal Therapy. I wonder what my opponent's gonna name. Taking Stifle, I don't even care. Opponent might just take Force of Will, would be my guess. I'd be most concerned if my opponent named Delver. Yeah. Yeah, I knew my opponent wasn't gonna name Stifle, even though I have two. Now I'm without pressure, that's pretty bad for me. So my opponent could be playing either Storm or Reanimator. I have a lot of disruption, but I'm going to need a clock or at least more lands. In two turns, I'm gonna have to discard to hand size. All right, looks like my opponent doesn't have a land either. Ooh, I drew Brainstorm. I clicked through my main phase, but it doesn't matter. I don't have any haste creatures. I could get one more draw. I think I'll do that. I really don't want to brainstorm lock my opponent, and I'm not really under any pressure. I misspoke there. Brainstorm. I think I'm willing to spell pierce that. I just want to get a card out of my hand. I'll get. Pretty tough decision here. I might just shuffle away this lightning bolt. I don't have that many more red cards. Think I'll get Tropical Island and spell pierce this. Definitely not gonna get Underground Sea. It's either Trop or Volcanic. Because my opponent missed a land drop, I wanted to spell pierce. And on my turn, I'm most likely gonna brainstorm if I don't draw a land. I really didn't like the idea of my opponent brainstorming into a land and then just playing a land and saying go. Then I'd be forced to be the next person to act and I would be under pressure. At this point, I'd say my opponent is most likely playing Storm. Alright, Cabal Therapy, that's fine. Opponent's probably gonna take Brainstorm. Brainstorm or Force. Yep, Brainstorm. I would have preferred to spell pierce that, but one thing that could have happened is that my opponent could have brainstormed into a land like this and just passed the turn without casting the therapy. Ooh, Delver was a very good draw. Right, there's another brainstorm. Definitely not going to force that. I'd like to draw a land, a cantrip, or a wasteland. So mostly I just don't want to draw a creature or another stifle. I'd say I'm about 50-50 to draw a good card or a bad card. Alright, Trop. Normally that's in Storm decks for Xanted Swarm. Yeah, my opponent has not drawn a fetch land to accompany these brainstorms. Ooh, I drew Wasteland. Maybe my opponent has Abrupt Decay. Alright, I'm gonna Wasteland the Underground Sea. My opponent didn't use the green mana right away, and I'd rather cut off double black. I really don't mind that the Delver didn't flip because my opponent was at 16, so it's not divisible by 3. So I was gonna have to get in 1 point at some point anyway. I really like this part of Legacy. Players just trade back 1 mana and 0 mana cards back and forth. Nobody's really gained any big advantage. LED. Not gonna counter that. Dark Ritual. I mean, my opponent knows that I have Force Will in hand. Cabal Ritual. Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, that makes sense. My opponent has 7, 8 mana total. If I let my opponent resolve the Past in Flames, I'm in really, really bad shape. I Probably the best way to have played against my opponent's hand, if I had full knowledge, would be to force will the LED. I would have won in that case, or at least prevent my opponent from winning. I don't think that I can win here. My opponent's gonna get a discard spell from my force, and then the Pass in Flames is gonna be lethal. Yeah. When my opponent cast LED, I knew that it likely meant a Pass in Flames, but I was just planning on countering that because my opponent also had Infernal Tutor. Yeah, it was like two big finish cards, and I had to go after the LED rather than the finisher. Yep, that resolves. Maybe I won't die. My opponent's gonna have to go pretty low on mana here. I think that my opponent is gonna go to. My opponent's gonna use the probes to try to draw a land or something, or a Lotus Petal. But right now, my opponent can only get to three from the Ritual, five from the Cabal. Oh, six from the Cabal. Yeah, that's annoying because my opponent will have threshold seven. Yeah, six from the Cabal. So then my opponent can Infernal Tutor for tendrils. Wow. All right. I could daze that so that my opponent can't brainstorm. If I daze it, I think my opponent's just gonna beat me, but I'm just gonna not cast anything to give my opponent an opportunity to mess up. Cabal Therapy can resolve. The storm has to be really high this turn. Right, my opponent named Daze. I think at this point, my opponent has six mana and needs to probe into a land. So that my opponent can Cabal Therapy, my Stifles, and then Tendrils me. Ooh, unless my opponent has Ill-Gotten Gains, maybe my opponent will get that. Yep, here's a probe. Oh, it is smart to tutor before you probe that way. You've thinned your deck of the tendrils. No, it's not smart, because then if the tendril's in your hand, it just saves you two mana for tutoring. Yeah, my opponent should have probed first. Yeah, my opponent anti-thinned. Alright, therapy. It's fine. Yeah, my opponent drew a petal, and then my opponent can kill me with. I wasn't actually guaranteed to die there if my opponent didn't draw a land or a petal. Alright. So against Against Storm, I can bring in Grudge or Grafdigger's Cage. I can also take out a Tarmogoyf, because I don't really want to get flooded on creatures. I want to draw pretty much exactly one. I'll bring in both cages and a grudge. I just want maximum disruption. My opponent saw Bolt, so I don't think the opponent will bring in Xantid Swarm. I'll be back for game... Hello, I'm back for game 3 on the play. Alright, this hand is good. I have lots of pressure. I don't really have much in the way of disruption. But I don't think that my opponent is going to kill me on turn 1. This is interesting. I've never actually played with this deck before. Pretty much always play Delve for turn 1. But with Deathrite, on the next turn I could deploy both the Delvers and still have a counter spell out. Or start to get to work on my opponent's graveyard. That's probably best. I'll just play... It does open me up to Cabal Therapy. I'm okay with Cabal Therapy happening. I'll just play Deathrite. Let's see what my opponent decides to play around with their lands. Alright, just basic island. My opponent gave me a land for Deathrite. I might not even have one. I could just play three Delvers. That's one possible play. I could play two Delvers and leave up my fetch land. I could start off with a Ponder. Yeah, there's no point in playing three Delvers. My clock is going to be the same either way. I do have a few red spells in my deck, but I'm going to get Underground Sea. I fetched before I pondered so that I can guarantee Delver flips. Alright. I'm not going to take this Ancient Grudge right away. And I will draw Daze right now. It's worked out pretty well. Pretty ideal. Play a Delver. So next turn I can attack for 6 and have Deathrite potentially to deal another 2. And I could play another Delver, so that's 8 and then 11, so that's exactly 19. Alright, now I don't need quite as much damage. I don't really have much disruption. My opponent, if my opponent has a really good hand, they could win. But next turn, I'll have a lot of disruption up. I'll have Stifle Daze and a Deathrite activation. Alright, Brainstorm, that's fine. Alright, Cabal Therapy. No sense. I don't have a land next turn, so I could Daze this. I'm just going to let it resolve. In case I ponder into a Wasteland or something, I want to be able to play it. All my cards do basically the same thing. Alright, my opponent did choose Stifle. Alright, because my opponent probed and strength, used Flooded Strength, the Deathrite, this third Delver, pardon me, is obsolete, has no use. This turn I'm going to Ponder, using the Trop. Alright, none of these do anything. Basically, I just want Force or Daze at this point. You ask and you shall receive. That's one thing I've learned in Magic. It's good to know what you want. I would bet anything that I'm going to win this game. I have a turn 4 kill on the play with a lot of disruption. My opponent's already cast a discard spell this game. This game, Deathrite was much better than Nimble Mongoose would have been. In the two previous games, it was exactly the same. Ooh, Duress. Yep, I'll just let that resolve. I'm not going to add to the storm. It is possible that I lose this game. LED again. Yeah. No point in dazing that, really. Dark Ritual. I could daze that to get rid of blue mana. Alright, I am gonna daze that so that I can get rid of a specific color of mana. Once the ritual resolves, my opponent has a lot of black mana. So this way I can get rid of some blue. The only problem is that I added to the storm when I might not have wanted to. Alright, let's see what else my opponent can do. Another ritual, okay. Infernal Tutor. Well, so I was thinking that maybe I would get to my opponent actually played very well around Deathrite Shaman, getting rid of Threshold. Had to do exactly this: cast Infernal Tutor, retain priority, and then cast Cabal Ritual. So well played by my opponent. I guess my opponent's going to get Ad Nauseam, would be my guess. Pass in Flames doesn't really do anything. What's the storm right now? 3, 6, 7. Yeah, so just getting Tendrils right away doesn't do it. That would just be a 16. Oh, my opponent can just do multiple tutors for Tendrils. So yeah, it is a guaranteed kill. I wonder if there's anything I could have done differently this game. I guess I would have lost a lot of money if I bet. Yeah. My opponent barely got to Threshold. Yeah. Let's see. If I didn't cast the Daze this game, this turn maybe my opponent wouldn't have it guaranteed. It looks like there's enough storm at this point. Yeah, it's well. It's exactly 20. So if I didn't cast the Daze, then my opponent would have had to have a different route to victory. Yeah. I guess my concern was valid of adding storm. Cannot gain life with my death, right? Well, yeah, I guess if I didn't cast Daze, I would have at least had a chance. My opponent would have had to cast Ad Nauseam and would have got to draw a lot of cards. All right, I guess I got what I deserve.